The first beta of OneUI 7 is finally here, and we have it installed on our S24 Ultra. There are a ton of new features, visual changes, and some inspiration here and there. I'll talk about everything, so hit the like button and let's get started. First thing you'll notice is that almost all the Samsung app icons have undergone a little bit of redesign, be it the gallery app, Samsung Find, or even the calculator. But the one that I like the most is the camera icon, as it's no longer of the same color as the gallery app, so you won't get confused anymore. The volume panel is also redesigned to make it look a bit modern, and the slider is now rounded. You can also enlarge folders like this, so you can access the app without having to open the folder, which is cool. The recents menu also looks much better with this new stack layout, as it's more modern and has a nice animation while you're scrolling through. I don't think you'd want to kill your apps after using this. With OneUI 7, you finally get a vertical app drawer with 4 or 5 columns, and I definitely like it better, but if you don't like it that way, you can just select the custom order and your apps will be sorted the usual way. The widgets also look much better now, like the battery, calendar, weather, and even the gallery widget. They are more vibrant, there are a lot of options to choose from, you can just resize them like this, and the widgets page is also a bit cleaner this time. One thing though, earlier we used to get multiple transparency levels in the widget settings, but it's not the case anymore. It's either completely transparent or not. And yeah, you can now change the app size like this, and can also remove the app labels to make your home screen look more minimal. Also, this new pill-shaped rounded battery icon with battery percentage inside it looks cool. Apart from all these changes, the quick settings menu has been changed into split style. So if you swipe down from the left, you get all your notifications, and if you swipe down from right, you get this completely redesigned quick settings menu. You can also swipe down from anywhere to access the notifications, and then swipe right to get to the quick settings, which is nice. And when you swipe down, there's also this cool bouncing animation, which looks quite good, and the background blur is also slightly better this time. Now, this heavily redesigned quick settings menu has different sections for connectivity, volume and brightness, media player, and other settings. You can also long press on sound and brightness sliders to get more controls, like this new volume normalization feature, which is cool. And earlier, you could access the quick settings menu by swiping like this, but now, you can tap here and it'll expand like this. You can also rearrange everything like this to make it your own, and if you don't like the split style, you can always go back to the older layout as well. One more thing that I noticed is that the notifications are also more rounded now, and if you have a bunch of notifications, they'll be stacked up here like this on the lock screen. Speaking of the lock screen, there are some interesting changes here as well. First of all, you get a few more clock styles to choose from, and the ability to show the date above the clock. There are also a lot more widgets to choose from, like this new gallery widget, which looks quite cool, but that's not all. Samsung also got this dynamic island-like feature that shows live activities like music, timer, voice recorder, stopwatch, and even charging. And when there's more than one activity happening, they'll be stacked up like this, and you can scroll through them like this. And when you tap on the music player, it expands and shows you the album art, just like They call this feature Now Bar, and it's really cool. By the way, these stacked live activities show up on the status bar as well, which is cool. For now, these live activities are only available for Samsung app. I just hope third-party apps make use of these, just like they do on iPhones. Also, while you're setting up the wallpaper, you get this new suggest option, which automatically gives you different lock screen styles, which is quite useful. The animations are also much smoother now, be it the app opening or closing, notification center, quick settings, and also this cool new charging animation that looks quite cool. Now, it's not matching up to the standards that ColorOS 15 has set, but it's good enough. There are some major changes in some of the apps as well. For starters, the camera app UI has been completely redesigned. Now they've moved all the controls from top to bottom, so it's ideal for one-handed usage. You also get a separate option to control exposure, you can control your frame better with grid lines and level, and the pro mode is redesigned as well with slightly cleaner UI. Lastly, you can now record video with music playing on your phone, which is cool. The gallery app also got some major redesign, but thankfully it's not inspired from Apple. Thank God. The bottom menu got slight makeover, there's a new raw image editor to edit highlights and shadows better, and you can create freeform collages where you can place photos and videos like this. The settings app main page didn't change much, only some icons got a makeover, but when you tap on the search button, you get these topics to help you navigate better. Other than that, in the digital well-being page, it now shows the category of the apps that you're most addicted to rather than the app, so you can get to the root cause of the problem. There are some new security features as well, including this new page where you can check security status of all your Samsung devices. devices. You also get more control over the power saving mode, and there's this new battery limit option with more control as well. The clock app also has this nice feature where you can group all your alarms so that you don't have to turn them on one by one. It's useful if you set up gazillion alarms to wake up in the morning, just like me. There are not a lot of new AI features this time. Maybe they are saving up for S25 launch, but you do get two very interesting features. First of all, you can now access the newly redesigned writing tool anywhere. So whenever you select any text anywhere, you can just tap on this icon to summarize or check the grammar maybe. Secondly, if you're someone who records your phone calls, this new feature is very handy, as it lets you transcribe the call and you can just go through the entire conversation like this. It's pretty neat, and you can tap anywhere and the audio of that part will play, which is quite cool. Plus, you can search through the conversation and it even supports Hindi, which is just awesome. I was also expecting Bixby to get some AI features, but all it got is this redesign. So yeah, that's the first beta of OneUI 7. What are the features that you loved and what are the features that you still want? Tell us in comments. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.